ameriški snemalci, ki so pa evropskih in drugih bojiščih tvegali življenje, da so nam ohranili podobe prve svetovne vojne. O njihovih podvigih in vojni propagandi govori knjiga Ameriški snemalci med prvo svetovno vojno 1914-1918, ki je šla ob lanski stoletnici Velike vojne. Trije avtori knjige so odkrili celo slovenski članek iz tistega časa o Hrstovem snemalcu Wallisu, ki je posnel prve nemške podmornice. Junaki, pretekli in sedanji je naslov karikature iz leta 1914, ki prikazuje, kako striček Sam, torej Amerika, snema svetovne voditelje na pragu morije, ki je za sabo pustila 8 milijonov mrtvih. Prva svetovna vojna je bila tudi prva vojna v filmskih podobah. Leta 1914 so ameriški mediji od Hollywooda do časopisnega mogotca William Randolpha Hearsta začeli v Evropo pošiljati vojne dopisnike, snemalce in fotografe. Javnost je vojno prvič spremljala v kinu prek filmskih obzornikov.
You could say that the First World War gives the first examples of foreign film propaganda. America was neutral from 1914 to 1917. And in fact, the Germans, they were the first ones to discover the potential of film as a mass propaganda medium. They set up the American Correspondent Film Company, which was secretly funded by the Germans, and they sent an American cameraman, Albert Dawson, from Indiana, to cover the German side of the war. The company was called the American Correspondent Film Company, which makes it look American and even neutral.
The war was big business in the United States. The British didn't need American help in publicizing its side of the war. Neither did the French. And the Germans also realized that they were getting terrible publicity because they had entered Belgium. They had developed poison gas. They kept doing things that sounded really scary. And so they needed publicity assistance. So they wanted to get people to tell their side of the story as much as they could. The problem there is that while the German Foreign Office and the ambassador to the United States might have realized the importance of trying to get something pro-German, the German army didn't like correspondents, felt they were probably spies and were probably at least a pests and a nuisance and so on. So they tended to fight very hard against sending these guys to the front. So a lot of them just sat in Berlin at the Hotel Adlon for a while and drank a lot and had a pretty good time and tried to get permission to get to the front when they could.
Ameriški snemalci so bili tako na bojiščih večinoma za avstro-ogrsko vojsko. Wilbur Darbara, ki ga je financiral nek nemški poslovnež, pa je bil eden redkih, ki ga je pod okrilje vzela nemška vojska in je z avtom prepotoval vzhodno fronto in celo posnel samega cesarja Wilhelma.
One individual document, I think it was Dawson, I believe, said that he carried about 200 pounds worth of equipment. Anybody that put a camera up was thought by the opponent would see this device and they would think he was a spotter or somebody and it would be a prime target. Basically speaking, it was dangerous. And even Durbero mentions in his travels, he was staying in a place near the front. He went for a day's drive, came back shortly thereafter, and the artillery barrage had destroyed the house. It took a lot of adventurous spirit, a lot of initiative, and the will to desire to actually capture on camera the history of what was transpiring across the East Front. And the only success going on in 1915 was the East Front. On the West Front, with the Allies, the French and the British, nothing was happening other than a lot of slaughter.
Večji del te filmske zapuščine prve svetovne vojne je bil uničen ali izgubljen že v 20-ih letih. Ko so leta 1917 ZDA stopile v vojno, so se ameriški snemalci pridružili fotografski enoti ameriške vojske, ki je bila del vladne propagandne agencije.